brace systems on the tropical radar.
And we also have the kickoff. And it will appear on your screen at some point. Where on earth is it? There it is. We have the kickoff.
And we look forward to the feedback from the viewers.
This week, right?
Oh, I'm sure the viewers will be pleased.
Oh, yes.
That's us on WN.
Killie in blue and white, Jupiterland playing in their home colours, both in their home colours actually, Jupiterland in orange and red, light orange and red. And yep, it's Killie on the ball in the first 2 minutes here. And will it be an early opportunity? Oh, it is! It's a goal!
That's
Would
already.
You believe it? Killie has scored within 2 minutes.
Jesus,
here.
Mother.
And we have early action in the HypoWorld Premier League.
That team fell asleep the first whistle.
Haven't they just? So,
what the hell, Kelly? That's the quickest goal, surely.
It is one of the quickest indeed. I'm not sure if it is the quickest, but it is a very quick goal here. And now will there be a possibility for Duke stand at the other end? They're wanting to reply quickly. This game could have some fire in it now. It's an offside call. That's really close.
Yeah, I'm a bit behind you and this team at the moment. Oh, for fuck's sake. Yeah. What a start that was.
So, Jupiterland 0, Killie 1 in the HypoWorld Premier League as we just tick over the third minute. Is that a corner kick for Killie?
Yeah, it's a corner.
Move it in towards goal. The keeper saved the first one, could still be a possibility. McCarthy goes down the box and he's given it the other way. It's not a penalty, it's a free kick to Jupiterland. And I think it's for a dive actually, and McCarthy could be in trouble. Yes, it's a yellow card. So
yellow
here.
Card there. For diving.
Can't you just tell that this game might just have it all?
Oh, I think this game certainly going to be what we expected.
No goals elsewhere. We'll let you know as soon as there are. Here's Evans for Jupiterland. On to Watson. Tony. Almost like Tony.
And this
will open.
That self-esteem hasn't gone.
Wonder whether Killie might do what they do best. They're a very good defensive team. Now they've got the goal, they might end up doing that all game. For the neutral, you'd hope not.
I hope not. I got a great start. Continue straight away.
Oh. It was just outrageous.
That's terrible. That's dreadful.
Here's Brady for Killie. He's tackled. And Evans will rush in behind and a tackle goes into on him there. And it's a free kick.
Yeah.
Just for future reference. Oh, chance.
That's it.
No, Tony couldn't get through, but Jupiterland do win the corner after a little deflection. Just so that everyone knows for future reference. Real players from real leagues can be imported into the HypoWorld Premier League, but it's up to the teams to decide to transfer them.
Right.
So some of the names you've seen might be real. Not seen any big names yet, though. One or two. Here's Stewart. Down to Morat, and he passes backwards here. And it's Jupiterland trying to consolidate well. I'd say that. But Killie have put it out of play, and it's going to be a throw to Jupiterland far up the field on the left hand side. 6 minutes played, and it's 1-0 to the away side. No goals elsewhere, there's plenty of games going on. Stewart. Newell tried to get the crossing, or it could have even been a shot, but it was blocked straight away, and any advantage they've had has been lost. 4:13 live. And a foul goes in there. So it's going to be a free kick for Killie, and certainly taking their time over it, and it's a short pass, and this I think is going to be the pattern that we're going to see Killie starting to employ. It's going to be slow play, measured, they're not going to take any risks. Morsi, Riveros, Gore, rounds his defender just about, but decides to not risk it and pass back. And the Killie fans in the corner in the away end enjoying this. Gore takes a tumble and Jupiterland clear the ball. You're watching Force 13's live streaming service in the ninth minute of the HypoWorld Premier League action between Lee's team Jupiterland and Craig's team Killie, amongst all of the other games going on down the bottom. And fouls here clear against box, Evans of Jupiterland, and the referee, is he going to reach for his pocket again here?
Let's give that back in, yep.
No, yes. It will be a yellow card.
Yellow card.
So, bookings either side now, but not goals.
It only sounds fussy, it's only 10 minutes out of the game and he's booked it for us.
It's a bit harsh.
Usually in the old ways, you don't get bookings to at least after 20 minutes or something.
Oh, it's gone too far for Evans, it's out of play, that's unlucky. It must be frustrating for you to see balls going astray like that, Lee.
Well, it's best not to concede the first minute.
Battle of the Scots going towards Killie at the moment. Jupiterland give it away, and again you'll have this Killie mentality.
Yeah, it looks
as if
Killie will actually play defensive football. Yeah.
I think there's no question that they will now that they've scored.
Yeah.
Jupiterland have got to give them a reason to not play that way, as Evans commits another foul. Killie might have a chance. Oh, it's well blocked. Corner kick.
I'm fire, Killie. I'm not surprised that's another good save.
Brady's corner. Met with a clearance. And Killie can't keep hold of it for too long. But Jupiterland have not done very well in clearing it. They're not getting out their own half, are they?
I think they've lost their self-esteem actually after that early goal. That's a problem.
Here's Mings, puts the ball forward, might have beaten the offside trap, looks like it. Here's Moore. He'll try and get the cross in. Does so, doesn't reach anyone until Riveros, and it's out wide in the end, not the greatest of shots.
It's a corner.
Headed towards goal, and the keeper's got that one covered. Seems to be lacking in any sort of direction for Jupiterland. They don't really know what to do, it seems.
Yeah.
But they've got a throw now. Jupiterland have the ball now in their own half again, and now will they try and get forward? Put it out to Evans. Now he's going to make a run on the right hand side. Can he do anything here? We'll cross it in towards goal. It's gone too far from everyone, and it's
goal
gone
kick.
Out for a goal kick. Disappointing when you see all that build up there, Lee, isn't it?
That is indeed. Yeah, they just need to try to get themselves back into the game. They're only 1-0 down.
David, what are your thoughts here?
Well, Killie's had one of those starts, but they'll be pleased that they're on the board, but let's see how it proceeds. But that was lucky.
Usually at some point we get a goal flurry in all the other games, but none have gone in yet elsewhere. 16 minutes played in all of those.
So we've been playing some interesting football here, I think. That's a fast right.
Oh. Yeah, looks like they're coming into the game a little bit.
Yeah, I was trying to go on.
And I must say, yeah, there's very, very few Killie fans there in the away corner. Yet you can still hear them audibly. They are some passionate fans
happiest.
Over there.
Oh yes, they'll be the happiest, isn't it? It's like Ibrox, the way I called them fans.
Corner for Killie.
Is it?
Yep. Just deflected out for a corner, yes. And Stuart makes a great tackle there.
Come on, chat up there.
Jupiterland makes some sideways passes, and as soon as they try and put it forward, it's a terribly misguided pass, and Killie win the ball back, and all that hard work is undone. Ruthless at times, the Killie players there trying to get the ball back, but here's a lobby.
That's going to be a corner, is it?
He heads it wide.
Goal catch.
Just missed it, the Killie player. And so it is a free kick awarded to Killie. 19 minutes played.
Tony can't reach it.
The keeper keeps it in and sends it on its way again and puts Killie back on the front foot. And here's Moore. Though he couldn't get through the brick wall. It was... Who was that? It's Watson now. Now it's onto Mole and Newell. It'll go forward to Stewart. And he
bit
gives it away.
Bit of pass. Yeah, bad passes at the moment.
It's Gorey.
Coming on the attack now inside.
Just hit it left. Riveros onto Brady. Killie looking somewhat menacing as they get forward, and Evans commits another foul. He's committed two fouls on a yellow now.
Yeah, so you need to be careful. Then he should be subbed.
Oh, hit the post! And Killie roll the second one in!
Oh, it's sad, it's 2-0. We're going to lose, I think. I think this is going to appear.
I think he tried the first one there, was it? And then he got the second one in. Let's take a look at the replay. It was McDonald that headed it, hit the post, and he just about got there first and tucked it past the goalkeeper. And Killie take a 2-0 lead.
After 21 minutes. Yeah, I think Killie are definitely going to win this now. I've got that feeling now. Killie are definitely going to hammer this again.
Oh dear.
Yeah. Not good.
No, it isn't. But you did get that feeling after a while. This seems to be the only game of the goals at the moment.
It is, it literally it is.
That's really weird, that, to all the others have got nothing and this one's got two.
Yeah. no goals anywhere yet. Except here.
Usually we're sitting here with no goals and other games with no goals. That's that to red for first half.
Just to point out the sun setting at Force 13 HQ. There it is.
Yep.
And Killie have another shot. And it's saved.
That's it, it's 45 minutes. So.
Jupiterland and Killie clear it very quickly. Seems that Jupiterland have run out of ideas at an extremely early stage. It's gone wrong from the first minute.
Yes,
and they do not know how to respond. Here's Tony. Can he respond? Watson. It's going to take some individual efforts here if Jupiterland are going to overturn the scoreline.
Got a free kick.
Morrett with the free kick. He's taking it short. Bounce onto Newell. And he takes a touch too heavy. And it's Smith who brings him out. And here comes Brady, who's been pegged back.
Oh, he's
given
a card to your anchor, sir. Yeah.
No.
It looks like a crooked fill.
And that goes out for a throw to Killie near the corner flag. I think they're starting to enjoy themselves. Could be another chance here. Brady, oh, it's off his own player. Goal kick. And that might have been on target as well if he wasn't there.
I think it was actually. Yes, it was. Quite the end of the video. They saw your speed there.
Hey, that's one way we could do an instant replay.
Yeah, I know, because it's a good 15 seconds or something.
Well, we've got our first goals elsewhere, and in fact, we have two.
Finally.
The Fools Republic have scored against Wawata, so it's Fools Republic 1, Wawata 0. Trying to assert their authority in the league at the top. They'll be up to 70 points with that win if they do win. And elsewhere, Grandpa David is his fictional name. Mineral Kingdom 0, Beach 1 is the score. Beach have scored.
Fantastic news. Fantastic news. Perhaps we should give the viewers a bit of a background info on Grandpa David. For our viewers, I was given that nickname on
the first day
that I actually joined the team.
It wasn't me. Oh, hold on a minute. Moore is still on goal. And he's put it past the goalkeeper, but over the bar. As you were, David.
So, when I came into the first chat, young Marcel has his own special way of attempting to get information, and he came up with the nickname. So, yes,
well, Marcel, if you, of course, you are officially a grandpa. If Marcel comes knocking, viewers, you can expect his first question, sort of like synonymous with him: how old are you?
Yes.
And what he says on the football pitch is usually "no more, please" when he's losing.
Yeah, Colombia played just now, is that later?
Yes, it is. Cidreira 0, Colombia 0, that's the latest score. No goals there yet.
Oh boy, just imagine if we brought Marcel back into the broadcast studio.
We'd have trouble.
Oh, bloody.
We would be in trouble.
He'd be in trouble, yeah, sure.
Your last 2 minutes, and he'll get he'll be given his marching orders.
And the usual half is like 69th minute as well.
Yeah, it's not going to that one. He'll be given a red card, I'm sure. Okay, here's Watson for Jupiterland, and he's just been appended there.
But force 13th, we're always looking for those that would like to come on board with us, because we do have a fantastic time, in addition to doing our live streaming. And for me personally, severe weather is one of my pet areas of interest. And one of the first storms that I personally tracked was Tropical Cyclone Yasi.
That's a goal kick. We've got a goal elsewhere. It is now Orilla 0, Rapid Marcel 1. So the inevitable has happened there. And that was actually a penalty that was scored. And here's Jupiterland with a possible opportunity now. Didn't seem to be able to take it seriously enough, that opportunity, I don't think. Anyway, 2-0 the score after 31 minutes. Veros. Tried to get it forward, but in vain.
Oh, I tried to get through there.
It's Gorey. He's tackled by Stewart.
Oh, it says put it on.
Third of the way through this game in the HypoWorld Premier League. Part of our evening of entertainment on Force 13's live streaming service. If you missed our storm update earlier, that is, I believe, is now online. The latest video on Force 13, and we will also have another one following at midnight UTC tonight.
Excellent.
And as the game progresses, we end up having less things to say because it's becoming less and less competitive. We've got a goal elsewhere. It's Coldland 1, Rega 0. A penalty's just been scored there as well.
Oh, I've doubled the half in here.
So, Adam's team have scored. Coldland 1, Rega 0. And it's another black mark on Rega's season if that stays the same way. But Rega have been known to fight back. That game is by no means over. And we've got a goal elsewhere as well. It's the Mineral Kingdom 1, Beach 1.
Good.
So the Mineral Kingdom have equalised against Beach. That's bad news for David.
No, right. I am hoping for a win.
Obviously.
So 1-1 now, is that? That's good.
With a throw in their own half, and well, they're not doing much with it. Oh, we've got another goal elsewhere. It is now Coldland 2, Rega 0.
Whoa, 2-0
there. So, a 1-2 punch going on there, the penalty after 33, and a goal from Jackson after 34. Here, Killie might have another opportunity brewing. Oh, not if they did that. Oh,
almost,
but he just couldn't quite reach it before the Killie player put it away. So, Jupiterland have a throw on the left touchline here. Newell's been tackled by Brady, and he might have been a little bit of trouble. Here's Newell with the free kick. Would Jupiterland do well from set pieces? Well, not that time.
Not this occasion.
I'm far away from half time. Lee, what would you tell your team at half time here?
I would tell them to get your butts into gear and start.
In no uncertain terms.
And start slowly, yeah. Want to win the game.
Be more passionate.
Yeah, be more passionate, yeah.
Yeah, well,
it's right, got another goal.
First half's been a disgrace.
Orilla 0, Rapid Marcel 2. So, Rapid Marcel having a good day as well. And the goals are starting to come in elsewhere, aren't they?
Yeah, you sure are now.
Evan steps in and comes another foul on the right hand side.
Fouls going on.
Floated in. Can they continue pressuring? Now onto the right. Gourmet will cross it in. It's cleared nicely. Don't forget, we have three games back-to-back tonight. This is the first one. The next one is coming up later. Galisa will be playing against the United Mictum. That's live here. And towards the end of the night, we will have Rain versus Haskane in a big basement battle at the bottom of the table.
Yeah, that'll be interesting.
I think it'll be boring.
No, you don't know that.
I think
that.
It'll be a bore fest, I really do.
Some of those games could
two
be good
teams
stuff.
Who can't score.
Well, you did have a point, Nathan. Some relegation games can be good. But it depends.
We'll have to see.
It's 80. I'm going to go for Haskin.
What's that?
I'm going to go for the away side in that game. Haskin, whatever you call him.
Haskin.
Yeah. And I think the Glissa game will maybe go for the Glissa.
One goes out of play. Goalkeeper makes a save from very distant. Wasn't really a shot, it was just a lob forward. Jupiterland trying to find an opportunity by being very direct.
Yeah.
Find themselves only going backwards here in the grand scheme of things. And that is a foul.
Foul to kill it.
We'll see. Downing. And Gore. And a big mistake here. And Moore is offside.
Oh no, Killie.
Now, girls, to tell you about elsewhere. Horse 13 live. Approaching the end of the first half of this HypoWorld Premier League game. Jupiterland 0, Killie 2. As it stands, Jupiterland are down from 10th to 11th because Rapid Marcel are winning. And this would put Killie 3 points behind Glissa, who play later. Crossed in. Chance for Jupiterland! They've got it!
Oh, they've got it. They've got to go back. Make it the day for the half.
Fantastic.
That's good that they've got to go back onto the second half.
And the fourth official has put up no minutes of added on time. So I expect
no
minutes
of added.
After the kick-off.
Last kick of the half. Imagine that. I'm glad they finally got a goal, so the half-time team talk wouldn't be as bad.
Well, they've definitely got something to hold on to now.
Did pull up then if there's no added minutes.
Oh, and that's an awful challenge from Evans. And that must surely be a second yellow card. Is it not?
Is
the referee's been lenient there. That did look like an awful challenge.
He probably
gave
the last
whistle,
one.
And it ends here. In the
Let's
end of the first half, 2-1.
That's half time. Jupiterland 1, Killie 2. Well, it's definitely a good game. 3 goals now. What a game! What a first half. Killie scored in the first minute.
Let me tell you about another late goal that happened. Orilla have got a goal back against Rapid Marcel as well. So Orilla 1, Rapid Marcel 2.
At least we're on the board, David.
Well, David, what did you think of the first half there?
Well, it's been entertaining. Both teams, they're providing those watching with a good game.
Yes.
Yeah, I think it's good so far. So.
Wonderful. Well.